Hello, and welcome to Financial Accounting. My name is Samreen Mandra, and I am a certified public accountant. The topic for this video is determining cost of goods sold using the first-in, first-out inventory valuation method, also referred to as the FIFO method. In this lesson, we will discuss the formula for determining cost of goods sold and inventory valuation method. The formula for determining cost of goods sold starts off with the beginning inventory balance, which is the cost of the inventory that was already on hand from the prior accounting period. Then we add in the cost of current period inventory purchases, and this gives us the cost of goods available for sale. If we subtract out the ending inventory balance from the cost of goods available for sale, we end up with the cost of goods sold. Now we will apply a simple example to demonstrate this concept noted on the right side of this slide. College Hat Company has a beginning inventory balance of 2 hats, which were purchased at the cost of $5 each. Therefore, the beginning inventory value is $10. During the month, College Hat Company purchased 1 additional hat, and the cost of this hat is $8. Therefore, we now have 3 hats, and the total cost of goods available for sale is $18. During the month, 2 hats were sold to customers, and there was 1 hat remaining in the ending inventory. This brings up the question, what is the cost of the 1 hat remaining in ending inventory, and what is the total cost for the 2 hats that were sold? The answer depends on which inventory valuation method is utilized. The purpose of utilizing an inventory valuation method is to allocate the cost of the items sold in order to record cost of goods sold on the income statement and determine the value of ending inventory reported on the balance sheet. We will briefly go over 3 inventory valuation methods, which are FIFO, referring to first in, first out, LIFO, referring to last in, first out, and weighted average. This slide demonstrates how College Hat Company would record ending inventory and cost of goods sold using the first in, first out method. The column on the left shows a portion of the cost of goods sold formula. The cost of goods available for sale is $18 for 3 hats. Under FIFO, the first 2 hats purchased at $5 each were sold. Therefore, the ending inventory would be 1 hat most recently purchased at $8, and the cost of goods sold would be 2 hats first purchased at $5, or $10 in total. This slide compares 3 inventory valuation methods. The column on the left shows a portion of the cost of goods sold formula, and the remaining 3 columns show the calculations under each of the inventory valuation methods. The cost of goods available for sale is $18 for 3 hats, which is the same under all 3 methods. As noted in the previous slide, under FIFO, the ending inventory would be 1 hat, most recently purchased at $8, and the cost of goods sold would be 2 hats, purchased at $5, or $10 total. Under LIFO, the most recent purchases were sold. Therefore, the ending inventory would be 1 hat, purchased at $5, and the cost of goods sold would include the most recent purchase at $8, and the purchase before that at $5, bringing the total to $13. Under weighted average, the average cost of 3 hats is $6 each, calculated by taking $18 dividing by 3 hats. Ending inventory would be $6 for 1 hat, and cost of goods sold would be $12. In conclusion, if we had more time, we would go into more detail and work through examples. Thank you for watching this video.